So he was a Gentile, and he's a great storyteller. If we read the two of the books he had written, the Luke and the Acts, I like him a lot. He is a great storyteller. He goes through details unlike others. Mark, he is a very rough writer. If you look into the gospel according to Mark, you will see the beginning of the gospel of Jesus Christ. This is how it starts. And the start. It already started, even before you thought. But Luke is not somebody likewise. He says, I have carefully investigated. That Mark was a great personality. Who was with Luke? Who was with Paul? Who was with Barnabas? He was a co-worker with Paul and Barnabas. In the beginning he was with Barnabas, and in the later part even Paul says that please bring John Mark. So, such a great fellow, but he is a very rough writer. But God used his writing. But look into the way how Luke writes. Luke says, I carefully investigate. Shall we just open our Bibles to Luke chapter 1, verses 1 on. Many have undertaken to draw up an account of the things that have been fulfilled among us. And understand, he is a Gentile. He is the only Gentile writer in the whole of the New Testament. Only Gentile writer in the whole of the New Testament. Many have written, so he is not saying, oh, why should I write? Or why should I investigate? Why should I bother myself? Why should I waste my time? For Luke, it is no wasting of time. And so he goes on to say like this, just as they were handed down to us by those who were from the first eyewitnesses and servants of the word, therefore I myself, who is this I myself? Say, he's a Gentile. Say, Gentile. A Gentile. Just like us, not from the bloodline of Abraham, but with faith, he came into the bloodline of Jesus. And this man, who is just like us, he says, I carefully investigated. Do you see that word? Underline that word. Because what we do is, we carefully investigate the word of God. We need to carefully investigate the word of God. You are preparing yourself for eternity. So don't think of it as a burden. I know you won't, but I also know that you would excel, because I know you excel in your academics. In the same manner, I believe and trust that you would excel in that exam. Academics, it's only for a time. Maths changes, right? Maths, does it change? There was a time when there was no E is equal to MC square. Was there a time when Newton didn't discover E is equal to MC square? Who discovered E is equal to MC square? You are confused. Who discovered E is equal to MC square? Students? Einstein, right? Who discovered the law of gravity? Newton discovered. So, Newton was a believer of God's word. Newton believed the word of God. And so, there was a time when they didn't know about the law of gravity. And you can change if you can prove much more than that, something greater than that. If you can prove 1 plus 1 is equal to 11, maths will be changed. Aerodynamics changes. Aerodynamics is not the same just as when Wright brothers discovered it. It changed. Now it is a complex thing. A great personality was telling, he likes artificial intelligence. Have you ever thought about this? And he said, young students should learn so much about artificial intelligence. And we need to invest much into artificial intelligence. But if you can invest into something better than that, then artificial intelligence becomes irrelevant or irrelevant. But there is no day as when this book will become irrelevant. Say amen. 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 That is why we learn the word of God.